Hi friends, it's Miss Amie here with West Virginia University Extension Service Family Nutrition Program. Welcome to my classroom here at Tasty Acres Farm. Today, we're going to explore crookneck squash roe. Do you know what a crookneck squash is? Here's one. Wow, isn't it funny shaped? So before we start to investigate our fruit or vegetable today, let's talk a little bit about my plate. I have mine here. My plate, when I say that, I actually mean your plate too. My plate is an example for us of how to get a variety of nutrients that our bodies need. This is a plate for mealtime. It includes 5 categories of food. Let's review each category and then see where our crookneck squash fits in. Let's explore the 5 food groups together. First, let's look at fruit. Any fruit or 100% fruit juice counts as part of the fruit group. Fruits may be fresh, canned, frozen, or dried, and may be whole, cut up, or pureed. Some examples include apples, oranges, peaches, strawberries, and cantaloupe. The vegetable category. Any vegetable or 100% vegetable juice counts as members of the vegetable group. Vegetables may be raw or cooked, fresh, frozen, canned, or dried/dehydrated. They may be whole, cut up, or mashed. Some examples include black beans, broccoli, sweet potatoes, corn, cauliflower, and sugar snap peas. The grains group. Any food made from wheat, rice, oats, cornmeal, barley, or another cereal grain is a grain product. Bread, pastas, oatmeal, breakfast cereals, tortillas, and grits are examples of grain products. Grains are divided into 2 categories, whole grains and refined grains. The dairy group. All fluid milk products and many foods made from milk are considered part of this food group. Foods made from milk that retain their calcium content are part of this group, including soy milk. Some other examples of foods from the dairy group include cheese, including cottage cheese, cheddar cheese, American cheese, and yogurt. The protein food group. All foods made from meat, poultry, seafood, beans and peas, eggs, soy products, nuts, and seeds are considered part of the protein food group. Some examples include chicken, beef, almonds, seafood, and black beans. So where do you think the crookneck squash would go? Do you think it would go into the dairy category, grain category, fruit category, vegetable category, or protein category? Take a guess. Vegetable category, correct. Our vegetable category provides us with a lot of nutrients that our bodies need. And crookneck squash are high in vitamin A, which keeps our eyes healthy. Say vitamin A. They're also loaded with vitamin C. Can you make a C with your hand? Vitamin C keeps our immune systems healthy. It helps prevent us from getting sick. Crookneck squash are also loaded with dietary fiber, which helps prevent heart disease. So let's investigate our crookneck squash. What do you think our crookneck squash is shaped like? It's a pretty funny shape. Miss Amie, myself, I think it kind of looks more like a cane, like it comes up and it curves. Try that with your finger. It comes up and then it curves, right? So almost like a cane. What color is our crookneck squash? Yellow, correct. How do you think the crookneck squash feels? It is very, very smooth. Can you think of anything else that could be smooth? Maybe the outside of a ball. Feels very smooth to me. This outside part of our vegetable is called the peel. And the peel also provides us with nutrients. So it's important that we eat the inside and outside. So what does this look like inside? Let's take a look. Okay, so here's our crookneck squash. Let's look inside. What do you see? What do you think these are? Those are the seeds. The seeds grow into new plants. What color is the inside of the crookneck squash? That's right, it's white or a really pale yellow. It's a lighter color than the peel. This part is called the flesh. How do you think the flesh feels on the inside? It actually feels really kind of like a little firm, but still wet, I would say. And it's kind of cold to the touch, maybe a little slimy. Let's try to dig out one of the seeds and look at what it looks like. Here is one little baby seed. So this is our crookneck squash. Let's learn how it grows. So where does crookneck squash come from? Crookneck squash starts from one of the seeds and grows into a plant and is normally grown in home gardens or in farms. Crookneck squash is what you would call a summer squash. There's two types of squash, summer and winter squash. Winter squash are like pumpkins and butternut squash. They have a thicker peel and they grow throughout the summer and you harvest them in the fall and you're able to store them and continue to eat them in the winter, hence winter squash. This squash, crookneck squash, is a summer squash. It is picked in the summer and eaten in the summer. So once a vegetable is fully grown and it is harvested by a farmer, it is then packed and sent to a grocery store. Or you could buy it at my favorite place, which is the farmer's market. You'll see these either in your farmer's market or in your stores, and that's where you can get one to try. This story today is called Up, Down, and Around. It's written by Katherine Ayers, and it was illustrated by Nadine Bernard Westcott. In the dirt, we'll dig a row. Drop some seeds and watch them grow. Dirt piles up, seeds go down, water splashes around and around. Corn grows up, carrots grow down, cucumbers climb around and around. Peppers grow up and potatoes grow down. Pumpkins vine around and around. Broccoli grows up, beets grow down. Green beans wind around and around. Okra grows up. Onions grow down. Tomatoes twine around and around. Fresh and tasty, get a bunch. Pick some, pull some. Let's have lunch. The end. So now let's go visit Susan in the kitchen as she makes crookneck pasta salad.
Hi, my name is Susan Lilly and I work for WVU Extension Service in the Family Nutrition Program. Today we are going to make crookneck squash pasta salad. Now, I want to go ahead and make the dressing first because I think it gives the flavors longer to mingle. So we're going to throw that in first and make it. So here is our 5 tablespoons of mayonnaise, fat-free mayonnaise, our prepared mustard, our basil, and our garlic powder, and our pepper, and our orange juice. It's gonna add a little bit of natural sweetness to it, I bet. And I'm just gonna whisk that up, and then I'm just gonna set it over to the side till we're ready to use it. Now, with your pasta, you want to follow the package directions on how you cook it, and you can use any kind of pasta. Whole wheat would be a great way to go of whatever type of pasta you use, but I went with rotini today, but that's what I had in the cabinet. You could use macaroni, you could use rotini, you could use shells, whatever type of pasta you want. And you're gonna cook that as the package tells you, but I have already pre-cooked the pasta, so it's gonna be ready to go. So I'm gonna set that off to the side. You're also gonna need your large squash. I have already cut the ends off of our squash, and I'm going to cut it in half, and you wanna be very careful. And I did pre-wash all and scrub all of our vegetables before starting, and my hands, just so we know. So we're dicing the squash. So I'm gonna cut it in a couple of layers, and then I'm going to cut strips. And you wanna watch your fingers and make sure they're not gonna be in any danger. Get my other one, cut it in half, or another wedge. And then we'll cut up my slices. And then I'm just gonna put them together, and I'm just gonna dice it up into little bite-sized, nice little pieces. Now, we are leaving the peel on the squash, so I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna pour it in my bowl. Got all my squash in there. The next thing we're gonna do is my carrot that I did scrub. And carrots are great. They are high in vitamin A. What we're gonna do with the carrot, now that I've removed the ends, is we are going to shred the carrot. So I'm just gonna take it, and I'm just gonna shred away. You want a medium carrot, medium size. So I'm gonna quit with this one little chunk. I may eat that as a snack. I'm gonna lay it off here to the side in one of my scrap little bowls. So I'm gonna get all of my carrot out of my scraper. Okay, I'm gonna lay that over in my scrap bowl. And this should come to about a half a cup. We have more than a half a cup, but I'm gonna throw it all in because carrot's pretty good for you anyway. So I'm just gonna throw it all in. I don't wanna waste any of it. Okay, we'll get all my carrot in. All right, so the next thing that we're gonna do, I have pre-washed my spinach leaves, and I've pulled all the stems off, and I pulled out any bad leaves that didn't look too appealing. You don't wanna eat those. And what you're gonna do is I'm stacking them on top of each other. And I'm gonna roll it up into like a tight roll. And then I'm just going to cut them in little slices, little slivers. There we go. And I'm going to do about 1.5 cups of spinach that way. So that looks pretty good. That's 1.5 cups of slivered spinach. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna dump that in. So we have our squash that has lots of nutrients in it for us that are healthy for us. lots of nutrients there we're getting from all of these ingredients. Now what we're gonna do, we're gonna dump in our half a cup of pre-cooked pasta, and we are going to add in a cup of cube cheese. Last but not least, I don't wanna miss any of this, so I'm gonna get my scraper. We are gonna add in our dressing. All right. And I'm going to mix up our pasta salad. Ooh, it's a beautiful colorful pasta salad. And I am going to just put a little bit in a bowl. This recipe would serve 5 adults, 1 cup servings, and 10 children, half cup servings. And so here we go. You have this wonderful recipe, this pasta salad, crookneck squash pasta recipe. And you can also find other recipes like this on our YouTube channel. So I hope you enjoy.
So today we're gonna get some physical activity. It's important that we move our bodies every day for at least 60 minutes. It keeps our heart healthy. Let's go visit Miss Shannon and see what physical activity she has for us today.
Hi everybody, I'm Miss Shannon, and today we're gonna be doing a seated exercise workout. First thing that we're gonna be doing are arm pumps. 25 seconds and then 5 seconds of rest. Are you ready? Okay, let's go. Good job, friends. This is a great exercise to help get our heart rate up. Awesome. Keep going. We're almost there. Okay, rest. Next, we're going to be doing a side lean. Are you ready? Okay, you can put your hands on your hips if you want, or put your arms out. Very good. This is gonna work our core. You're doing great, friends. We're almost there. All right, rest. Next thing we're gonna be doing is a shoulder press. Up and down, and reach to the sky. You can make fists if you want to. Good job, we're about halfway through. Up next, reach overs. Are you ready? Go to each side. You want to take your arm up, over your head, and lean to the opposite side of your body. You're doing great. Good job. Excellent work, friends. Almost done. Okay, we're gonna rest now. We're gonna be doing arm circles next. Arms out from your body. Ready? Let's go. You're doing great, friends. You can go a little bit faster if you want, or you can make it big wide circles and go a little bit slower. If you'd like to, you can also come out into the front of your body. Good job. Almost done. We're almost finished with our workout. Next thing we're gonna do is cross jabs. Fists up and just jab across your body. Excellent work. You can go as fast or as slow as you like. Just be careful and stay comfortable. Awesome job. Go ahead and rest. Okay, I think this is our last exercise. We're gonna reach up and we're gonna reach out. So up and push out. Up and out. Good job. Out. Up, out. Up, out. Way to go, we're almost done. And we're resting again. Now we're gonna stretch. Stretching is very important after we do any physical activity. So we're gonna take one arm across our body and just give it a good pull. Great. And then we're gonna take this arm and do the same thing. Great. Stretch up high to the sky and lean. Good job. And let's lean this way. Good job. Now we're going to take a big deep breath up, reach to the sky, breathe out, and bend down. One more of those. Up and down. Fantastic job, friends. I hope you had a lot of fun. Thanks for coming.
Hi, my name is Tracy, and I work for the West Virginia University's Extension Service Family Nutrition Program. And today, we're gardening in recycled containers. So when I was walking around the house and the office and I was looking for different things to plant my plants in without spending any money, I started to see all different size and shapes and colors of containers that we can use to grow our vegetables in. So if you look at this one, can anyone guess what it might be? So this is actually a cottage cheese container, or it could be a yogurt tub or any other kind of like bigger tub. The biggest thing when we're using plastic, so in my my water jugs here or my giant pretzel bin here, whenever we're using plastic or a container that doesn't have any holes in it, we need to make sure to add those holes so that the water doesn't fill up like a bucket, but it can actually drain out the bottom in case we get lots of rain. So when using plastic, we always want to poke holes. You can use, with a parent's help, we need to make sure to be safe. So you can use like a little screwdriver or the top of a scissors. Once again, make sure you use your parent's help when you're poking your holes. And just a few holes around the bottom will allow the water to drip out and not drown our plants. So we can use plastic containers. My herb garden here is made out of water or milk jugs. So this one is really fun. And then we always want to make sure to label what we're planting. So I like those ones. And then another really fun one is, what's this? This one is made from an egg container. So I've cut off the top and we can actually use both. If I was gonna do microgreens or something, I could do it in this tray here. And for my bean seeds, I'm gonna use the bottom of the egg carton here. So when we are using our egg carton, we're gonna take our soil and we're just gonna sprinkle into all of these cracks. And each one of these is kind of gonna act as its own little pot. And when we put our soil in, we wanna leave all that air in there. We don't wanna smash it down. If you're using really tiny seeds, I like to water my soil first so that they don't go swimming around. But if I'm using big seeds like my bean seeds here, that's okay. So I filled it up to the top, each one of my little crevices, and then I'm gonna take my green bean seeds. These are bush beans, so that means they're gonna grow in individual little bushes instead of being pole beans that grow nice and tall. So I'm gonna put my seeds in to my each little hole. And I like to sometimes put all my seeds on first so I don't forget which container or which little crevice here has a seed in it, and then I can go back through and push them all down, and then we're gonna water them. So this little container here, I started 12 bean seeds, and it didn't cost me any money for a pot because this is temporary until my beans are big enough to be transplanted. And then always make sure to water really well. So I can use my egg cartons, and I can even use the top as a little tray. And then I thought I would show you how to make a newspaper pot. So these are really fun. You can use old newspaper and you can make it as big or as small as you want. So you need a round container. You can use one like this. You can use a jar, you can use a mug, pretty much whatever you have. And we're going to use half of a newspaper sheet. So when you get your newspaper, it's big like this. We're only gonna use half of it. So you're gonna cut it down the middle on the long way. And then we're gonna fold our newspaper in half. And I like to keep all the corners. So this corner and that corner. And then we're gonna crease it. I'm gonna use my finger. And so now I have my folded edge and my unfolded edge, my open edge here. I'm going to use my open edge. It's gonna be the bottom of my pot. So I'm gonna take my round water bottle and I'm gonna roll it. And I like when it's nice and even. So I'm gonna roll it nice and tight. And if it doesn't get tight enough, you can undo it and you can do it again. So we're gonna roll, trying to keep it nice and even here. So I've wrapped it all the way around and then I'm gonna push it to the end so that there's space. And then all I'm gonna do is fold my newspaper down like this. And I'm gonna go all the way around so that I don't see the bottom of my water bottle anymore. And then I like to take it and kind of rub it around so that I'm creasing the bottom. And then just like that, I've got a little pot. It might be opening a little bit, but once you put your soil in and you water, it will kind of stick together. So I'm gonna fill it up. Remember, we don't smash down our soil. And then I'm gonna water it really good because I'm gonna use some little seeds in this one. So as you see, once it's wet, it kind of sticks together like glue, and we've got a little paper pot. So when you're looking for containers, you don't need to spend lots of money. Like I said here, I use a yogurt container. This is an old pretzel container. This one is a reusable shopping bag. These are great because they already have holes in the bottom, like kind of like the webbing is, the water goes through. So I can use those and they're really fun and bright and colorful. This one is an old basket. So I hope you guys get creative. You can look for all different containers to use as your pots. Make sure to always put the holes in the bottom for drainage. Hope you all have a great day and you find something really cool to plant in. Bye.
Thanks for joining us today for Grow It, Try It, Like It. We're always happy that you are here. Have a great day.